No, you've been a good friend, and that's in the thick and thin, and I know it's never gonna end. Cause you've been a good friend.
This is Chucky Lad. Welcome to the Fireside Chat. I want to talk about climate change today. I think climate change is real, I think it's massive, and I think it's happening now. I think in large part it's man-made. I'm a man of science and I believe scientists, and I'm desperate to do something about it, but there just does not seem to be belief out there in the community, certainly in Australia or in the USA. I think it's different in Europe because they're seeing the effects the further higher you go in the latitudes, whereas Antarctica's a long way from everywhere, and we don't really see what's going on there. People that I've known for years, I come from out west where it's certainly more nationalistic, much more patriotic area of Australia, and out there, out in the bush, no one seems to believe in climate change. No one's not fair, of course, but the majority don't seem to believe in climate change. I've had conversations ad infinitum, but one in particular springs to mind where the argument was against climate change was, I reckon it's all bullshit. What about volcanoes and shit? I'll articulate the argument for him. I guess he's saying there's all sorts of massive explosions and stuff, you know, chemicals and gases and all the rest of it going up into the air all the time, and they're huge, and you know, you get ash from in Australia from a volcano in Indonesia, blah blah blah. How can you possibly say that a few cows farting is worse? In short, just even articulating it sort of lays that out bare. I'd say, well, inferential analysis, I suppose, answers that pretty well. Why would you think, in this case, a truck driver, why would you think you know more than scientific consensus? It fails me. The same person I had a conversation that I was talking to, I also mentioned on a different topic that he'd need to be start looking for other sorts of work or to start training up, because a truck driver is really not going to exist. They're still going to have truck drivers, but it's going to be not a need for a lot within a decade. And he, you know, absolutely just panned it and said, "Nah, it's 50 years, and you try and drive a truck from, I don't know, White Cliffs to Ivanhoe or Broken Hill to Kalgoorlie or something, and you're never going to do it." I beg to differ. Certainly the driverless technology's there now. It's only just requires a bit of work. It's there. It's more the like reliability and the loading and fueling and all those sorts of issues. Obviously you're going to have driverless fuel trucks driving along and stopping and fueling trucks, and the trucks are going to be going 23 hours a day rather than 8 hours and having a camp and a gut full of beans. It's got to be safer. It's got to save lives. It's got to be more efficient. When it all boils down, it means money, so it'll happen. But that's not what we're talking about. We're talking about climate change. I think it's too late. I think we're all gone. I think that we've dithered too long. In my life, I can certainly remember conversations 10 and 20 years ago saying we have to do something in the next 5 years or it's too late. And it's 20 years down the track and we've done sweet jack shit. And there's a few, the Paris Accord and the Kyoto Protocol, and obviously I support all that sort of thing, but with the state of play in the States today with Donald Trump, we're fucked. She's gone. There's a megalomaniacal, crazy, fascist loon in the White House that doesn't give a rat's ass about one single thing other than himself, including the Earth. It fails me. He's what we could do is tell Donald Trump that he could be remembered as the best man to ever draw breath on the earth. He could be the most famous person ever and the person remembered for energy and for saving Earth, for saving the planet, for saving humankind. It may not be true, but we could tell him that. And if we got into his ear enough, and turned his attentions to that, with his disgusting guile and tactics, the horrible jackbooted fashion that he roams around, he may well be able to do it. I mean, we sure get your Vlad, your mate Vlad, to just keep away for a bit, and how about Vlad and you and G all not spend your defence budget this year, the three of you, and you'll be all safe, no one's going to spend anything, and you put it into renewables, you put it in to taking away the need for the Middle East, and all of a sudden we haven't got a problem. We don't need the oil. They haven't got the power. We're saving the planet. We're cleaner. We're not polluting. I just don't get it. Why? I don't think we need to have climate change as a reason to do that. We should just do it. It makes sense. I do think that any honest to goodness, real attempt at climate change, without a doubt, is going to cause massive economic destabilisation. Unfortunately, I just see it as a given, unless somehow all the superpowers got together and just did it. And the massive economic stabilisation is going to be horrible, and there'll be rioting and killing, and it's all going to be in vain anyway. Fat ladies sung, the horses bolted. Sorry about that.
No, you've been a good friend, and that's in the thick and thin.